Good morning, everybody. Welcome to Live at 5:55 on this Wednesday morning. Hope you guys are doing well. If you have your Bibles, you can open them with me to James chapter 1 as we continue our study through the book of James. Yesterday, we started the book of James looking at James chapter 1, verse number 1. This morning, we're going to look at James chapter 1, verses 2 through 4. So James chapter 1 is where we're at. I hope you guys are having a blessed morning. I'm just going to read these three verses and then we'll dive into them. Some very good stuff that James is going to get our minds set on this morning. He says here in James chapter 1 verse number 2, "My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. But let patience have its perfect work, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing." So he lets us know back in James chapter 1, verse number 1. Here's the deal. He said, "Hey, I'm a bondservant of Jesus. At the foot of the cross, the ground is level. Even though I'm the half-brother of Jesus, I just see myself as a bondservant." He goes on now in verse number 2 getting the start of his epistle, of his letter, and he says, "My brethren." He addresses us as the church, as believers, as fellow brothers. Again, he doesn't say, "My brother Jesus." He says, "Y'all are my brothers." He says, "My brethren, count it all joy when you encounter various trials." This is not necessarily what we want to hear on this Wednesday morning. James says, here's the deal. I want you to count it. That's a banking term. I want you to reckon it. I want you to count it all joy when, and notice that word that's used there in James chapter 1, verse number 2. Not if you fall into various trials, but when you fall into various trials. I want you to count it all joy when you fall into various trials. There's a promise from the Word of God that we see this morning, and that promise is that you as a Christian are going to fall into various trials. And truly, they can vary. We all go through different stuff. We all experience different trials, but the one common denominator between us all is that we all do, in fact, experience trials. And James says that when you see yourself experiencing a trial, count it all joy. Be happy about it. My brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials. Why? How am I able to do that? Verse 3 tells us, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. He says, here's what I want you to do. When you experience a trial, he says, I want you to count it as joy. This is fascinating what James is doing, because watch this. James is teaching an interesting principle that I've had to remind a few people of this past week. And it's that you cannot control very many things in this life. But one of the things you can control is your attitude. And James says, here's the deal. You can't control the trial. When you face the trial, whatever it is, you don't have any control over that. But here's what you do have control over. You have control over you. You have control over what you're going to do, how you're going to respond, what your attitude is going to be in this trial. And he says, for the Christian, he says, I want you to be joyous in that trial. There's so many things in our lives that we cannot control. There's very few things in our lives that we can control. As people, we love focusing on the things that we can't control and getting upset about that instead of focusing on the few things that we can control. One of the only things that you and I can control in this life is our response to things, is our attitude towards stuff. And James says, I want your attitude to be joyful. When trials come, when life gives you lemons, James says, I want you to not only make lemonade, I want you to sell it too, right? He says, I want you to count it all joy when you fall into these various trials, and they vary. Knowing, verse 3, that the testing of your faith produces patience. Okay, life throws a trial at me, whatever it might be. We've all experienced this, and if you've been saved and you haven't experienced trials yet, take comfort, you will. It's going to happen when you fall into various trials. Here's what we have to realize. as we, the reason why we as Christians need to take a trial and choose to be joyful in it, verse number 3, he tells us, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. Knowing that this trial that you're now going to go through, it's actually going to produce in your life patience. The trial's not fun, but you're joyful in the trial because you know what the outcome of the trial is going to be. And the outcome, the fruit of the trial, is patience in your life. Man, another word for patience there would be endurance. You're going to be able to endure. You're going to learn endurance through counting joyful the trials that you're going through. You're going to be patient. You're going to be enduring. Now, endurance is a great thing to have. It's a sucky thing to learn. Endurance is so good to have, but when you're going through it, it is not fun. And I experienced that just in my own hobbies in bike riding. When I ride my bike, there comes a point where you ride for a few miles, you get tired, but you mentally block out the tiredness, you push, and all of a sudden, you get kind of like this high, honestly, these endorphins, and you're able to endure through that pain of, I think it's time to turn around now. You say, no, I'm going to go one more. I'm going to go one more mile, and you're building up endurance. And before you know it, you've ridden farther or longer or whatever than you ever thought you could, because you pushed through the hard part. You said, man, my body is telling me, my mind is telling me that I could turn around now and that'd be a cute little ride. But if you can tell your brain, if you can make it up already, no, I'm going to keep on going. You produce endurance, and that translates over to other parts of your life. You see, when life gets hard, the easy thing to do is to stop, to turn around, to go back. But God says, for my people, they need to realize that when life gets hard, that's when they need to push in a little bit more, to build up that endurance, to have that patience worked out in their life. He says, knowing that the testing of your faith produces patience. Why do we want patience? Verse 4 tells us, but let patience, let endurance have its perfect work, that you as the Christian may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. The Lord says, I want you to learn endurance, to learn patience, because when you learn patience, when you learn endurance, it's actually going to help you become whole. It's going to make you more well-rounded, and you're going to be able to be complete. You're actually going to be lacking nothing. Part of us being conformed into the image of Jesus is learning the concept of patience, learning the concept of endurance. And as much as we read the Bible, we have books, we have all sorts of Christian books, but endurance cannot be learned. Endurance has to be experienced, and the Lord knows that. So he says, you can read books about trials. You can hear other people's testimonies. You can watch these cute little YouTube videos about patience and endurance. But he says the only way that you're going to know it, the only way that you're going to get patience, get endurance, is if you actually have to go through it. And again, the Lord gives us all different trials to go through, but he gives us those things so that we can be complete, so we can be more well-rounded, so that we can obtain, so that we can have that endurance that he wants his children to have. We want endurance. We want patience. Why? Because patience makes us complete. It makes us who Jesus wants us to be. Is it fun? No, it's not fun. It's not good at all, honestly. It's hard sometimes. You want to turn around in the middle of it. You want to throw your hands up and give up. The Lord says, it's going to be okay. Have joy. Notice in these three verses, there's three main things, three main words we need to focus on today. He says, my brethren, count it all joy when you fall into various trials. The first thing we need to do is count. We need to count it all joy. We need to reckon it joy. That's the thing that we control. Life gives us lemons. We choose to make lemonade. We have trials. Our job, I'm going to be joyous in this. What this isn't is positive thinking. What this isn't is fake it till you make it. Don't be in a trial where life sucks and pretend, well, I'm just going to put a smile on my face and no. Really have joy. How do you really have joy? How do you really count it as joy? Because, this is the next word in verse number 3, because you know. You count, verse 2, you know. Knowing, verse 3, that the testing of your faith produces patience. The thing that allows us to count the trials as joy is knowing what we know, knowing God's word, knowing the Lord is in control, knowing that He's doing a work in our lives. If you know that, it's going to cause you to take a circumstance that isn't even fun, but to count it as joy, okay? The key to the joy is knowing who, knowing the Lord, knowing the Father knows best, knowing that even though it might not be fun right now, He's got a plan, He's got a purpose, and you're going to come out better on the other side of this through the patience and the endurance that you're going to gain. So you got to count it all joy because you're knowing the truth that God is in control, that He loves you. And lastly, in verse number 4, He says, but let patience have its perfect work in you, that you may be perfect and complete, lacking nothing. That last word is let in verse number 4 that we need to grab a hold of. We need to count in verse 2, we need to know in verse 3, and we need to let patience have its perfect work. Let it just happen. Don't fight it. Don't try to shelter your way from it. Don't try to avoid it. Face it head on. Go into it realizing that I cannot change what is coming at me, but I can change my attitude. I can count it as joy. And the reason I'm able to count it as joy is because I know. Knowing, understanding the truth, understanding who Jesus is, that we have a good Father, and that He loves us. So, whatever trial you're facing right now, and I'm sure you have one, and it varies, various trials, as James says, from mine to yours to the next, we all are going through stuff. God says, I get that. He says, I kind of designed it that way. Because the stuff that you're going through, if you count it all joy, because you understand the working that I'm doing in you, and you let that patience have its perfect work in you, He says, you're going to build patience, you're going to build endurance, and that's going to make you more complete, that's going to make you more into the image of My Son, and that's part of this life, actually. Endurance, patience is not something we can just read about and obtain. It's something we have to experience. And it's tough when you're going through it. When you're through on the other side, it's a great attribute to have. It's a great thing to be able to learn. Endurance and patience. This is tough stuff, that's right, but it's true. So let's pray for God to help us in that today. And then we'll continue on with this morning. Heavenly Father, God, we thank You for today. And Lord, we all are facing various trials. And Lord, they differ from one another, but Lord, we all have that in common. Lord, we're going through stuff. Lord, life gets messy, life gets hard, life gets tough. But Lord, You've called us as Your kids. Lord, that when life is tough, Lord, that when we go through various trials, Lord, that we are to count it as joy. And Lord, the reason why we can look at a situation in this life and see it as joyful, Lord, is ultimately because we have the joy of the Lord. God, even though the circumstance is not fun, Lord, we can still have joy in it, knowing that what You're going to produce in our life through that situation. And Lord, what You're going to produce in our life is patience, endurance. And Lord, that's a mark of a mature Christian. Lord, that's a mark of a bondservant of You. Lord, being able to say, even though this isn't fun, I'm going to push through it because I know that on the other side, whatever I gain from this experience, this knowledge, this patience, this endurance that I gain, it's going to be worth it because it makes me more complete in You, Lord. So God, give us that endurance. God, help our minds and our hearts when we fall into various trials. Lord, not to whine, not to complain, but to count it all joy, Lord, knowing that You're at work, that this trial is working out Your goodness in our lives. And as a result of that, Lord, we're to let patience run its course, let endurance do its thing in our situation, in our life, Lord, knowing that we will be complete in You, lacking nothing. That's good stuff. That's a good promise. Lord, that we're more equipped than ever when we go through stuff. So, Lord, help us just trust in you with this stuff. And Lord, I know you're going to give us plenty of opportunities to exercise, to practice this stuff, even just today, but Lord, throughout our lives. So help us just keep a good perspective, God, that you are good, that you are in control, that you give us stuff. Lord, we go through trials. There's a lot of stuff we can't control, but Lord, what we can control is our attitude. So help us be joyful in you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. I hope you guys have a great Wednesday morning. That's right. All things work together for good. And that's the beauty of it. Not all things are good, but all things work together for good. Count it all joy, no matter what's thrown at you. You count it all as joy when you fall into various trials. Understanding, realizing that all things eventually work together for good. They're not all good in the moment, but they work together for good for those who love God and those who are called according to his purpose, and that would be you and me as his children. See you back here tonight, hopefully, at Wednesday. Tonight's Wednesday, 6:30. We'll see you tonight for our midweek Bible study, Deuteronomy chapters 26 and 27. Tomorrow morning, live at 5:55. James chapter 1 verse 5, now that we've learned about patience working in our lives, that we're complete, lacking nothing, he's not going to say, but if any of you lack wisdom, he's going to tell us where to go through if we are lacking. In James chapter 1 verse 5, that's tomorrow morning, live at 5:55. Hope you guys have a blessed day. Some kind of heavy stuff to deal with, but it's way practical. It's stuff you're going to experience day after day after day in your Christian life. And just realize your job is to count it as joy. You cannot control the trial. You cannot even control the outcome sometimes. But what you can control is you. And you are to have an attitude of gratitude. You are to choose to be joyful no matter what this life throws at you. And sometimes you're going to break down. Sometimes you're going to cry. Sometimes you're going to complain. That's okay. You can have your moment, but you got to get back up. Though a righteous man falls 7 times, Proverbs says he gets back up. It's okay if you have your little mental breakdown and you got to deal with it and you need to just whatever, whatever, whatever. That happens. The Lord understands. You got to get back up. You got to keep pressing in. You got to keep allowing that patience and that endurance to work out in your life because it's going to make you complete. It's conforming you more and more and more into the image of Jesus, and that's what we want. So, hope you all have a great day, and I will see you later on tonight.